Nashville, Tennessee. The whole of downtown Nashville likely still reverberating with the sounds of the Titans taking the field a moment ago. They're ready for football as their Titans are set to match up with the Chicago Bears. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Running down. They just get the playoff. Now Mariota, eluding the pressure right. And a run! And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. An 11-yard pickup for the Titans and a first down. Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a game. Now, first down for Derrick Henry. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down. That goes down as a loss against his rushing stats. But really, should he have to absorb that one? He had no chance on that play before they overwhelmed him. Pretty much on top of him before he could take his first step. Mariota now on second down. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. It's a pickup of 12 and they'll set up a third down. So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players in the space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get them out in the flat, and let them have a chance to make people miss an open field. Now get the completed pass, but still have more to go here on third down. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. And a loss of three to bring up four. The third pitch, he pretty much expects straight ahead runs, and this one doesn't quite go that way. And it certainly didn't help him trying to pick up a first down. Now trying to get to the outside, lost yardage. Okay, look at this. The punt team nowhere to be found. They're on the sidelines. Offense going to go for this on the opening drive. They're indeed going. It's Mariota. It's complete. Henry. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. It's a pickup of 21, and the Titans are going to have a first. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground. Well, he's got a double burst in his step. That's a big pickup right down first down. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. Only a gain of a yard, but that's all they need, as that's going to move the chains. Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. How big the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs, and we'll still get the first down. They love being physical. Now here's the first down for DeMarco Murray. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Every yard go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they got to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through. Off play action to Henry. Here's Mariota. And he's caught back at the 10-yard line. And he carries this one all the way down to the 9. A good pickup there at 20 yards. He'll try to run for it with Henry. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. A pickup of 4 on first down. It'll be second and goal. So that run gets him about halfway home. He has now second and goal. The end zone beckons. It moves. They can do whatever they want. Full play block. Run it again. Or they can go play action and try to put it in that way. Only a yard there on the keeper. And that's going to leave him with a third down. And they got it to the 4 on this opening drive. But now they face a third and goal. Losing yardage to the 7. With the former volunteer Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It's the Titans with the football here to begin quarter number 2. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. They've already gone for it and made it once on this opening drive. They're going to try it again on fourth down. From the shotgun, it's Mariota. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tennessee. Eric Decker, a 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Titans take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. And this is good. Our score, 7-0, Tennessee. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And nice work on the return as he'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. So the D-line's going to spread out. They'll begin the drive with Howard. And he'll be tackled just past the 35 at the 36. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up 75. Again, it's Howard. And he'll grab a gain of 5 out of this up to the 41-yard line. 5 yards there. Remember Howard last year, 5.2 yards per rush, so right around his average. The only Bears running back that's averaged that many yards per carry in a single season, Walter Payton. And Jordan Howard can keep up that type of pace, the city of Chicago is surely embracing. They'll try to run for it with Howard, and he brings this up to the 46, good enough for the first. It's a pick up of 6 and good enough to move the chains. Another nice run there by Jordan Howard, and when we talk about fresh legs, how about 2016? Jordan Howard, the number 2 rookie rusher, heck, the number 2 rusher in the NFL, behind another rookie, Ezekiel Elliott. In the first 3 weeks of the season, he only had 12 carries, so once week 4 hit, really found his groove. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. See, now players understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays. I'm glad I didn't make it in that league. That would have a really difficult time. But now you can still do it in me. Yeah, that's fun, isn't it? What a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them. On first, they go right back to Howard. And he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him a yard down to 43. Nice job by a defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say. Yeah, only getting 1 yard, there was no room to run. touchdown, Trubisky. His throw incomplete. The Steelers have to make it easy for him. They're difficult group, but we just saw it there in that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in. Now play number 7 of this drive, and it's a tough 3rd and 9. From the shotgun is Trubisky, going up top. And incomplete, the contact made the ball roam free and brings up 4th down. Trubisky and the troops staying out there. They will go for it. 4th down. Here's Trubisky. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. John Fox is pleased with how that turned out. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on a turnover on downs. Prescott on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 41. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be 2nd down. Now, that play was doing right from the start. Nice game, gets him 8 yards closer for 3rd down. Okay, he's not going to get the 1st down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit. Throw it, Mariota. They set up the screen for Henry. So they call off the tackle, and that effort gives him the 1st before he's brought down. So a minute 55 to go in the 1st half. Back to Tennessee after this. Here's Mariota, option left. Now, he probably should have given that one off as he's going to get hit and taken down behind the line. That'll go as a loss of 5, and it'll make this a 2nd and long. Working out of the gun, Mariota. And they can't get the long connection as it falls incomplete. Eric Decker, the intended target, and it's 3rd down. They're going for a receiver there. Already has 1 touchdown in his 1st half, a 2nd one not to be.
Look where the head space is, though. I mean, I really like the thought process, right? You got a guy who's already scored 1, right? You want to go back to him, continue the hot hand, and make them adjust to you defensively. I like what they were trying to get done, even though they weren't successful.
And the Titans on 3rd down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 15. From the gun, Mariota. And this is going to be incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys that call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
He'll look to throw. Guy's hand complete over the middle. That's Riley. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. It's a big play that time on a fake punt. They're on 4th and long. Somehow, they're able to keep the drive going. Make a play action here on 1st down. And Matthews over the middle with a grab. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. Get him 9 there on the 1st down completion. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively. But the defense, so you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do. It's not something that's really evident when you watch it on the screen. But everyone's talking, communicating, playing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover.
And it's down there. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the 1st half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Yeah, at least 3 points, get that 0 off the board. They couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
The one thing that I like defensively is that they've shown a lot of different looks here in the 1st half. They come after them, they snap back. I think that's what you need to do to keep offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Now Trubisky to throw. They complete the right side away. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
Watching the wide receiver screen, because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? That guy's going to get all the credit, but how about the people at the block in front of him? Either fellow receivers or offensive linemen, that makes up for a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
On 1st and 10, it's Trubisky. And no escaping this time, it's he'll go down. They got him for a sack. And before the 2nd down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this 1st half of action. On 2nd down, here's Trubisky. The catch is made by Kendall Wright. And before they can run this 3rd down play, we're going to get a timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this 1st half. We're still in search of the 1st down after that last completion. Trubisky now, the throw on 3rd down. He's going to let this one go deep. And that is
Another drive comes and goes, still nothing on the scoreboard. Yeah, and when the second half comes in, it's really easy to get discouraged and wonder if you're ever going to get things started. Just gotta fight through, gotta keep pounding away. Here's Pat O'Donnell now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. With it is Jackson. That'll be a 44-yard boot, just a yard on the return as he's covered up quickly. And it'll be Titan football. The Titans offense gears up for their first possession of the second half. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? And they score here, especially a touchdown, it's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think they're going to call their plays accordingly, because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on, because you can take the spirit away from another team. They're driving and will to come back and win, and you're thinking, well, another score right here. Still third quarter, but you just get that feel.
Yeah, they're cheating right there on the brink, aren't they? It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Sometimes with a running game, you just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Get him 3 yards on the run there. That still leaves him with a difficult 3rd and 8 coming up.
Third quarter, you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out. But a running game can really benefit your team right now.
The Titans on 3rd down. 2 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 8. Play fake to Henry. Now Mariota. He'll have a 1st down. Pass the 40. And Luke Cage Walker complete. 17 yards on that play for the Titans.
There's so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, don't care about that. And your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? That's playing the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. Mariota, and he fires one that's intercepted. Adrian Amos for the pick, and his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything in a route like this. He's trying to drive that football into a tight spot. If you're a little early or a little late, chances are he's going to be somewhere there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
They go with Howard to begin the drive. And good pick up there. He gets about 6 up the midfield.
He's had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that, there's a little bit of a hole that closes quickly at the end. They bring a receiver in motion left. Score game.
And now it all comes down to philosophy, right? Is that a big return for a touchdown, so the momentum is high. And now he's going to run. Derrick Henry all alone. He's at the 40, past the 20, 10, and he will score. Touchdown, Titans. Derrick Henry, an even 90 yards. And the Titans banter against the wall, deep back in their own territory, and they run all the way down into the end zone. That takes a lot of coordination for an offensive team, doesn't it? Because, first base is really not a surprise that they're going to run the ball in that situation. Now they're that close to their own end zone. Usually do call running plays, trying to be safe. Instead, it turns into an electrical run, a bolt for your team, and off he goes to the races. This will take him just inside the 10. It'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive, but they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They've got their game plan now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction, because as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard. 7 yards to pick up on a pitch and catch.
Now Trubisky to throw on second. They'll set up the screen to Howard. And they'll get it out just short of the 45 at the 44. We'll give them 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn a break set of downs. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, yeah, you got two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to 14-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a hole each time you snap the ball.
All right, first down, they run with Howard. And he's got it across midfield and down to about the 47-yard line. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gap.
And he's a guy that has some height to him, so when you don't have to drop his shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it's a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make the runs we just saw there.
From the gun, it's Trubisky. And right with it here, over the middle. And he's going to get this one down right to the edge of the red zone of the chalk of the 20. A very solid gain of 27.
Never make the mistake of the slot receivers, especially the little guys that we're watching here. They're just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed. They catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
Looking to throw, Trubisky on first down. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
This defense is definitely worth the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe you can expect more passes like that downfield. So the incomplete pass brings up second down. They run play action for Howard. Now Trubisky. And not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone. This drive, which is going so smoothly, all of a sudden it's a little bit of a roadblock here with two straight incompletions.
Yeah, Kyle, this defense is adding up. Apparently they're saying, no more. Let's take a stand right here, right now. But it is third and 10. They got to get after him one more time.
On third down, Trubisky. And he hits the tight end. It's Deion Sims. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up the first and goal. Now a play fake here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got a touchdown. Leslie Woodyard in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. They go play action with Trubisky. And this is caught down for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They had a touchdown they needed. They felt like the defense is out of the ball. Okay, you got a touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, offensively, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, yes, you build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way down, they had a touchdown, it's almost like,
You know, doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Titan offense now as they make their way back onto the field. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense may be expecting a run here.
Parker, I love your description because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about passing play. Something in the air, deep ball, but they're just taking it. Big time jaunt. Now they're coming back out. Now they've established this run game. The play action pass could very well be open.
So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's second down. Rolling here, Mariota going with a screen for Murray. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. And now the Bears going to signal for another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here. Then we'll be back. Mariota, buying time to his left. And he fires one, but incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he let it just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
Here's Brett Kern now. On presumably a punt, though he did complete a pass earlier. He'll send this up to the Nashville skyline, and it's a good one. Punt of 48, and the Bears take over. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. They're down here in a one-score game, but the time is a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation. What game situation? What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They call these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
And they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. Give them 12 yards on that one, it earns them a fresh set of downs. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Now before the second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go in the game. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. Yeah, a little aggressive too early.
And he did line a quick takeoff as the ball was snapped, but I think sometimes with big guys on offense, they're pretty cagey too. Like, they make little sudden moves and little subtle moves and get to the jump.